Hi, this is Jay of Nappy Beauty. Let's talk about hair, baby. Let's talk about kinks and naps and all that stuff. Let's talk about hair. Well, today we're going to talk about all that stuff. This is my second video for my weight loss challenge, the 100 days of exercising every single day, eating better, drinking more water, and finding a plan that works for me. I'm getting closer and closer to a plan, you guys, so hang in there with me. I wanted to tell you guys today, I did not lose any weight because Sally is in town, and I know that I have fluctuated between a loss of 3 pounds, a gain of 5 pounds. This morning I got on the scale and it said I lost a half a pound. So for my own mind's sake, I'm not counting this week because I know that my body fluctuates greatly when Sally's in town. You guys know who Sally is, right? Aunt Flo and Mary, all the same person, our little visitor. Anyway, I just wanted to let you guys know that I am staying focused. I am not going to run out and get some chips and eat because I did not lose weight. I am an emotional eater. I have learned this about myself. I eat to celebrate. I eat because I'm disappointed. I eat because somebody else wants to eat. Whatever. I'm on for the eating. But I'm learning not to do that. I'm learning not to self-sabotage myself. Thanks again, Parvy, for reading the book or mentioning on your channel, Stop Self-Sabotage by Pat Pearson. Stop Self-Sabotage. I read this book in a matter of 2 days. It's an excellent book. If you guys think that you don't self-sabotage yourself, read this book and I beg to differ. We all want to believe we want the best for ourselves and we set ourselves up in the best situations, but I know that I self-sabotage myself. Just like I mentioned, you know, if I hadn't lost weight and I've been exercising 5 days a week, doing Tai Bo and 2 days a week doing yoga, walking or whatever, I'm like, I did all that work, ate right, did all this, and I didn't even see a loss. Let's go get some chips. But I'm not doing that now. Oh, yay! To let you guys know, I conquered Tai Bo Advanced. Woohoo! Yes, I did it. Now I'm moving on to boot camp. You know I'm doing Tai Bo 5 days a week, and on the weekends I'm doing either walking, yoga, or some form of lower impact exercise. I did Richard Simmons Sweating to the Oldies. I sweated, but it wasn't a Tai Bo sweat, but it was a good sweat on yesterday. Today I'll do yoga. Okay, I want to go over this book a little bit for you guys so that you know what's in the book and if you should get it. I'm just going to go over the 5 different types of self-sabotage because I did this video twice already. I'm running long on time. So, I don't want to break it up in parts. So, here we go. Okay, the first type, throwing it all away. This, I can give you an example of people that win the lottery and they end up broke the next year after winning $5 or $6 million. They were not ready for it, nor were they prepared for it, so they threw it all away to get back in their comfort zone. Settling for less. We all as women have done this in one form or another in our professional life or in our personal life. You know, you want the, you know, the gold star, but since you couldn't get the gold star, you go for the silver. Okay? We've all done it. You know, you see the goal in sight, but then you self-destruct just before you grab it. Resignation sabotage is where you give up before you even get started. This is so common for me with dieting. You know, why diet? It doesn't work, so give it up. You know, why do Tai Bo 5 days a week and I see no pounds coming off the scale? Whatever, I'm giving up on that. That's an example. The fatal flaw sabotage. Perfectionism, procrastination, untreated depression, narcissism, and I added one, all or none. Perfectionism, you know, if it's not perfect, then why do it? You do it right or don't do it at all. I am a little guilty of this. I'm such a perfectionist that now I'm learning to accept excellence. Do it to excellence point. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it has to be excellent. excellent, and that's a big difference. Procrastination, you know, I'm a procrastinator on some things. Like, I wouldn't be here saying I want to lose 100 pounds if I had started a year ago. So I procrastinated. All or none. I am such an all or none person. You know, whatever. If you can't do it, if I can't do it all the way, why do it at all? Not a good thing. And the last sabotage is denial. We've all been there. You know, you look in the mirror and you see what you want to see. Well, I'm not that big. My butt's not that big. These jeans look all right. And you start to minimize and rationalize, intellectualize, or generalize. Everybody's gained some weight. So what? I gained a little weight. Whatever. You know, you start to bargain with yourself. And, you know, I can have chips, but I'll just exercise a little longer. These are all in the denial sabotage. I've done all of those. And a great thing that she points out, and the big objective to get out of this book, is about your deserve level. What do you say and believe you deserve? You know, we all have a point of, you know, this is what I deserve in my life. And if we get outside of that, we get uncomfortable, and we could bring it back down to the point where we're comfortable with it. That can be success. It can be in our love life. It can be whatever, you know. But what we need to do, and what she points out, is change your deserve level. You know, I deserve to be healthy and fit. I deserve to wear a size 14 or less in jeans. I deserve that. And I'm going to work, and I choose to work and exercise to get there. I choose to educate myself. I choose to get to this level of desire. So she says what we get what we believe we deserve. We get what we believe we deserve. It's the same thing as Scripture says, you know, so a man, what is it, you... So a man believes, oh my God, I can't believe I forgot that. Oh, as well, okay, this one, this is another point. As a man thinketh, so is he. Okay, so that's the same thing. Okay, the final thing I wanted to tell you guys about this book is she points out the difference between self-esteem and self-confidence. You know, a lot of people put those together and lump them in one little thing. But she points out the difference, and I thought this was a good point. Self-esteem is unconditional acknowledgement for your own worth and lovability. Self-confidence is the conditional acknowledgement for your performance. So, you can be an excellent photographer and can take pictures like nobody's business, be the best at your job, and know this. And you can still have low self-esteem in that same thing that you're confident about. You can still feel bad about yourself or not deserving of the opportunity to take pictures of the President of the United States. Oh my God, why me? You know, even though you're confident, know that nobody else can do it like you, you can still have low self-esteem in the same sense. I thought that was really great and a wonderful point that she pointed out in her book. This is only the first half of the book. I finished the whole book in like 2 days. I'll give you guys what you can do to combat this on my next video because I don't want to run out of time again. Also, I wanted to tell you this week I am going to do a fruit fast. I'm fasting on fruit and water only. We'll see how long it goes. My goal is to do it for 7 days and see how my body feels because I am exercising every single day. So we're going to listen to my body because I've learned that the hard way. On Thursday, I didn't really feel that well. I was doing my Tabo, doing my kick. And then, you know, all of a sudden my head started to hurt, didn't listen. Then next thing I know, I'm running to the trash can, okay? I should have listened to my body. So this 100 days is great for me. I'm listening to my body. I'm finding a plan. I'm eating better. I am drinking more water. I am getting this together. And the big thing for me is today I do not feel like I need chips or ice cream because I did not see a great loss on the scale. So I am making progress, guys, and I hope that you are too. I hope that you're learning that this is a journey and not a destination. So I'm glad that you're listening. I'm glad that you're here, and it's going to be all right. I found this, and I thought it was so great. And I hope that you guys can agree. The greater the obstacle, the more glory in overcoming it. I believe this. I believe it. And I know that this too shall pass. So you guys hang in there. I'll see you on Wednesday or Thursday, give you an update, since Sally will be packed and gone by then, and tell you what's going on with my weight and tell you how I'm doing on the fruit fast. Keep it strong. Keep it positive. Keep it moving. This is Jay of Nappy Beauty. Have a glorious day.